Hi guys, a very good afternoon and welcome to Africa and Beyond Television Network. We continue to take a look on what is happening in the nation Zimbabwe. Without fear, without favor. Mnangagwa, vadzoka kubva ku China, where he attended a FOCAC summit as well as a state visit. He was there for almost 2 weeks, and VP Chiwenga has been in charge of the affairs of Zimbabwe as a nation. So, Kozwa says he went to China with over 100 delegates, including security details. Each one of them was getting $2,000 per day allowance for 2 weeks, all coming from taxpayers' money. Apachabuda apana. Zim is in real mess, misplaced priorities. So this is it, Team Zimbabwe. We need to take a look onto these allegations being raised by Kozwa right here. Remember, Kozwa is allegedly run by a man called Mnyaradzi Shoko. This has been confirmed. Nana Donza Msoro, they always respond to Kozwa, affiliating it to Mnyaradzi Shoko, who is believed to be an ally of VP Chiwenga and untouchable. They fear him a lot. That man is untouchable, clearly untouchable, because despite whatever he says, despite the differences and everything else, they cannot touch him. We do not know the reason why they are afraid. And you know that once they have done that, vanengeva bata muswe wembada. So if you take a look, about 100 delegates vanengeva kaenda ikokoko, let's say each one of them is paid 1,000 every day. That is $100,000 ninge chibuda. In this case, this is $200,000 iri kubuda on daily basis, plus or minus $200,000 every day iri kubuda ichibhadharwa wa madelegates iwayo. If you calculate 200,000 by 10 days, that is $2 million for allowances only. If you add another 4 or 5 days, you would understand that over $3 million was paid in allowances, if these allegations are true. So when we have teachers opening, vachitaura kuti isu hatisi kufara because hatisi kupiwa mari inotenga mari inokwana. When delegates, including bodyguards, were paid mari inosvika kuma 3 million for 100 people only. Guys, zvinzwe sirofamba zvakanaka. We really need to have priorities in our nation as a country. We really need to have a second thought about the resources which are being wasted by these people. Schools in rural areas are in tatters, bad shape. You know, I have kids who are in grade 7 at this point in time who are struggling to raise funds. Number one, for transport for them to go and write examinations. But number two, most importantly, they are struggling to raise the funds for food. This is an honest reality which is happening. They are struggling to raise the funds for food because they are going to write examinations far away from their original schools. They are learning at satellite schools. And when it comes to the time of writing, they go to other schools. The government is not intervening. The government is doing nothing. Parents are building school blocks for these kids to be able to learn at their respective classes or schools. But the government is prioritizing traveling. And what do you bring from all those travels? Nothing. So you can actually see that what Kozwa is raising right here is something which can't be ignored by any reasonable person. Very, very important issues being raised right here. And we hope and believe that one day these issues shall be debated live and publicly without any fear or any favor. So remember, President Mnangagwa is back. We'll talk about that. He's back into Zimbabwe. And this is the end of the acting presidency of Vice President Chiwenga. So far, he has been applauded by the people for allowing the release of key activists who were arrested during the August month of July and the month of August, in fear of mass protests. Remember, the regime was trying by all means possible to control the situation, and in doing so, they arrested so many activists. Some of them were pulled in planes. No one was safe during the month of August, and as we continue, no one is safe, especially for those speaking against the regime, because they feel that their agenda 2030 is being threatened. This is Team Zimbabwe taking a look on each and every individual. Ngati ti aipadarwa $2,000 per day for 14 days. That is $28,000 plus. Imagine, guys, kungoenda 2 weeks, wodzoka wane 20,000 muhomwe. Just imagine kuti vanhu ivavo, do you think they will ever want kuti government ichinje? No. So this is the reason why you see they will do whatever they can to actually oppress others and maintain the status quo. But when it comes to those who are being paid crumbs, because if you are a soldier or a police officer or a government employee earning $400 by 10, that is $4,000, and by another 2 months, that is 800. So if you calculate, put it together, you see that the amount of money you will be getting will not enable you to even get a quarter of what these people got in 2 weeks. This is the reason why we have been calling this government to be serious about these discrepancies. You need to give the people who work for the people of Zimbabwe reasonable salaries. You have to give them marino and rana, nema costs, or with the cost of living. So that is the reason why we have poverty datum line. You have to use the poverty datum line to make sure that you pay them reasonable salaries, which makes them be able to send their kids to school, save, and pay for other services and goods. This is Team Zimbabwe. This is what Kozwa is raising. Remember, Mnangagwa vadzoka nhasi, and we will be covering those topics and those issues about his return. Vadzoka vakabatei kana kuti vadzoka kumusha vakamarembedza. A very interesting moment in the nation Zimbabwe. Remember, the succession issue is the hottest topic ever, and ZANPF people believe kuti they are entitled to continuous leadership. But kuna wangu warukuto believer kuti Shumba Mramgi is entitled more than any other person. Even waruku za NPF kwachu warukuto nzi, you are not entitled to leadership. Mnufana wangi tanga masungwa, mfana utanga ma swapa death sentence, mfana utanga ma cross border, jamba, mjitiza. Mfana utanga ma mambo jika poison for you to be able to be the rightful candidates for the presidency. We do not know if there is an agreement on that perspective, but we'll take a look on what is happening after the return of President Emmerson Mnangagwa later.